Medical experts say that diabetes can be easily managed, and the best way is through proper diet and change of lifestyle, particularly for type 2 diabetes, in which a person's body is unable to effectively utilize the insulin it produces. This type of diabetes is commonly found in adults, but is increasingly affecting children as well. According to the Kenya Diabetes Management and Information Center, more than 85% of people living with diabetes in Kenya are type 2.
A lot of patients who have diabetes do not know they have diabetes. So they may be having symptoms, maybe losing weight, maybe passing a lot of urine, but they are not being diagnosed as having diabetes.
Type 1 diabetes, on the other hand, is commonly known to strike in childhood or adolescence. In this case, the pancreas stops producing insulin, the hormone that enables people to get energy from food. Type 1 diabetes lasts a lifetime, and those affected therefore have to take multiple injections of insulin daily to survive. It is also possible for children to acquire type 1 diabetes at an early stage if the mother did not exclusively breastfeed them for 6 months.
Our mothers, because of the nature of their work, because also they feel that maybe the kid is not getting satisfied to the breast milk, they start supplementing that with other foods, and this also is creating a lot of poor metabolism and obesity and eventually diabetes.
Nevertheless, there are various support systems for people with diabetes. One-stop diabetes clinics exist in all provincial hospitals in the country. A diabetes youth camp is organized every April by the Kenya Diabetes Management and Information Center and the Diabetes Support Center at the Kenyatta National Hospital.
For those type 1s, they really have to manage their diabetes by injecting themselves at least twice or thrice daily. So those ones, we have a project where you're able to give them free insulin with the World Diabetes Foundation.
It is important to know how to manage diabetes because it has devastating effects such as kidney failure, blindness, heart attack, stroke, and pregnancy complications. Generally, a nutrition plan for a person with diabetes includes 10 to 20% of calories from protein, no more than 30% of calories from fats, and the remaining 50 to 60% from carbohydrates. When it comes to individual management for type 1, then one should regularly monitor their blood sugar levels, take insulin injections to regulate the use of sugar in the body, follow medical experts' advice on diet and exercise program. Hemoglobin tests should also be done in every 2 to 3 months to check blood sugar control. However, insulin therapy is different from person to person. If you have type 2 diabetes, eating a well-balanced diet and getting regular exercise is extremely important to manage it. However, one should also take medicine as prescribed, monitor blood sugar levels regularly, and control your weight. Olivia Ketch, Sunday Live.